The most prevalent trauma that I see is loveless parents to their children. And until that betrayal is removed, these folks will live from the pain of that betrayal. It'll cause disease, it'll affect their relationships, and that absolutely is the most common thing that I see, is the pain of the betrayal of loveless parents. Well, the first thing that has to happen is there has to be an awareness, which comes as we go down the road together, that these negative emotions are tied to physical symptoms. It's a hard stretch for a lot of folks. It was very hard for me. I'm a male. Women generally get it much faster than men do. But anyway, then what they'll see as we go in class together week to week, that there will be some exposure that causes physical symptoms. To cause a physical symptom, you would think that someone fell off stairs and that's where the right side of their hip hurts. And what you find is they didn't fall down the stairs, they saw their father, you know, and all of a sudden you've got all these things going on the right side. Things that happen with fathers tend to manifest physically as symptoms on the right side. Things that happen with females or mothers tend to manifest physically. And so they have no other explanation for this pain. And then I point out, no, you had an encounter with your father. And then what I'll do is I'll get them to focus on it, get rid of those emotions from childhood, and then shortly their pain on the right side totally disappears. And what it does, it makes believers out of them as we go down the road together in class. Because obviously we live in a society that sees us as physical machines based on Newtonian physics, and we are much, much more than that. We are here for love, and just as, you know, the physical world would understand that if you bounce off a tree, you're going to hurt. Well, man, if you're still bouncing off your parental betrayals from childhood, you're going to hurt, not only emotionally, but physically. And recognizing that, working with it, getting rid of that pain, improves relationships, quality of life, reduces anxiety and depression, and makes you more functional physically. Well, I don't think any of us like pain, you know? And so when we relive those times of betrayal, it's not pleasant, it's painful. So we'd rather bury it and move on to painting the fence or seeing the movie or playing some basketball or knitting or whatever it is we do that brings us peace. But the problem is, to remove that pain, it's going to continue to speak to you until you turn and face it and remove it. And then you won't need all these distractions. But why do we not deal with these things? One is you don't really know how. I think you need some life under your belt to understand that emotions are not your reality. You know, you get angry, and because you're angry, your thoughts change, and it justifies the anger. That's the first stage. You made me angry. And then you start to realize it's about how you respond. And so there's a growth required. But in the early days, all we know is pain is unpleasant, whether it be physical pain or emotional pain, and we just want it to stop. And the easiest way to get pain to stop is to avoid it. And that's expensive as we get older.
Thank you for watching. If you found this video interesting, please click the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified every time we release a new video.